Wise men say only fools rush in, but I can't help falling in love. Did you already hit record? Let's just get to the title scene then. Hi, Mr. Seligman here, and welcome to the music room. These past few weeks, I've been trying to learn a new song that one of my choir students has been asking us to sing in choir. You know who you are. But the song, if you recognized it, it's called Can't Help Falling in Love. It was recently popularized by 21 Pilots back in 2012, was it? Was it really 8 years ago? Man. Yep, 2012, 8 years ago. Whew, time has flown by. Anywho, Tyler Joseph, the lead singer of 21 Pilots, isn't exactly the original singer of that song, or the songwriter for that matter. It was actually written years and years ago, back before I was even born, in 1961 by none other than the king, Elvis Presley. Essentially, 21 Pilots decided to do what we call a cover. What that means is when an artist takes someone else's work and does their own spin on the music. Just so you can get a taste, in case you haven't heard it, we're gonna listen to the 21 Pilots version of Can't Help Fall in Love. Let's check this out, alright.
Wise men say only fools rush in, but I can't help falling in love with you. Shall I stay? Would it be a sin if I can't help falling in?
That's pretty solid. Now we're going to listen to the original version sung by Elvis Presley himself. And before we listen, a couple things. First off, this was written, almost 50 years ago. So it's going to sound different, obviously. Some people might feel it sounds more classic. Some people might feel it sounds more ancient. Whatever your views of that generation, I want you to listen to this with fresh ears and think about a couple things. No, it's the same song. It's going to have the same melody. Maybe the same chords. But what sounds different? Ask yourself, what sounds different as we listen to the original version compared to the 21 Pilots version? Sounds good?
Wise men say only fools rush in, but I can't help falling in love with you. Shall I stay? Would it be a sin if I can't help falling in love with you? Like a river flows.
Sure. Alright, I'm gonna put pause in there. But first off, what sounds same, what sounds different? The melody or the hit tune sounds the same, obviously, but not always. In different covers, you'll hear them change melody. It's a fun fact. But what's different? Well, if you listen to Elvis Presley's voice, it's much more, those deeper notes are like, someone just drinking a big cup of water. Oh, it sounds so nice, those nice low tones. With Tyler Joseph, 21 Pilots, his voice is very different, much more higher pitched, much more of a stretching sound, and neither is better or worse. Just gonna be on your personal taste. So we said the singing sounds different. What else? Well, Tyler Joseph started out with the ukulele. He's starting out with just one instrument. Later on, you hear this backtrack coming in. But Elvis, straight up, is with a full band. And it makes it sound much more full. However, I'm not trying to trash on Tyler Joseph. I like what he did as well. He's playing the ukulele, and later on, as you see in the video, he's just sitting around with some random people. I'm really hoping those are random people, not someone he paid. But he's just playing with some random people, and later on, you'll start seeing that he's singing with a group of people, be it people on the streets, be it people in a live concert. And also, you kind of hear that background noise. It makes it sound like it's just more just raw. And also with Tyler Joseph's version, it seems more like, you know, people sitting around campfire, you know, singing Kumbaya, except Can't Help Fall in Love, and just like it's the song of the people as people sing together. It's a very different feel. These are two different approaches, and some are gonna like that raw feeling, and some people are gonna like that more produced and warm feeling. It's up to you. But that brings me to the question I have for you today. Now, put on your big brains, it's gonna be important. Why do musicians cover other musicians' works when they could just listen to the original on Spotify or YouTube or Google Music or what have you? What I want you to do is send me your thoughts. It might seem like an obvious answer, but to you, your obvious answer might be different than someone else's obvious answer. You can send your thoughts via email listed below, jonathan.seligman@cvesd.org. Or if you're one of my current students, you could send it to me through Teams. Or if you're more Twitter friendly, you can also send it to me there at Mr. Seligman, MrSeligman. And for brownie points, I want you to find two songs. One is going to be a cover, and the other one's going to be the original of that cover. And I want you to tell me, what is different and the same between the two? And you don't have to go super philosophical on me. If you just state that the original uses a piano while the new version uses a guitar, that works. But if you want to go deeper, go deeper. I implore you. But guys, girls, ladies and gentlemen, everyone under the sun, it's been fun. I'm probably going to be jumping between the musical activities we usually do and also this more thinking stuff, just to change things up, okay? But until next time, I hope you explore, you experiment, and listen to some awesome music.